सॉल्यूशन ऑफ ए ट्रायंगल। सो इन प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ट्रायंगल्स वर द मीनिंग ऑफ सॉल्यूशन ऑफ ए ट्रायंगल, राइट। इन ट्रायंगल एबीसी देर आर सिक्स एलिमेंट्स। इन ट्रायंगल एबीसी देर आर सिक्स एलिमेंट्स। थ्री आर एंगल्स, एंगल ए, एंगल बी एंड एंगल सी, एंड थ्री आर साइड्स। ए इक्वल टू बी सी, बी इक्वल टू सी ए, सी इक्वल टू ए बी। So angle A, angle B, angle C and opposite to angle A, small a side BC, BC equal to A, CA equal to B and AB equal to C. When any three elements, except the case of angles, when any three elements except the case of angles are given, it is possible to find other three elements. This process is called solution of triangle. When any three elements except the case of angles are given, it is possible to find other three elements. This process is called solution of triangle. Now, why we are mentioning the except the case of three angles is, so if these angles are given, then we can have several triangles, that is several similar triangles can be possible. That's why we are excluding this case. Solution of right triangle. Solution of right triangle. So one right angle is given. Solution of right triangle. So angle C equal to 90 degrees. And let us say two sides A and B are given. Solution of right triangle. One case is two sides A and B and a right angle are given. Then that means here three elements are given. To find the other three elements, there are several possibilities are there to find the other three elements. Now one of the possible solution. Because you'll have several ways to find the other three elements. So one of the possible solution. because we are having the sides A and B, I can apply sin A. So instead of sin A, I can apply tan A. So tan A equal to A by B, because A and B are known. From this, I will get the angle A. After getting the angle A, then angle B will be equal to 90 minus angle A. Now, we need to calculate the C, because it is a right angle triangle. C square equal to A square plus B square. This is one possible method to find the other three elements when three elements are given. Not necessary that you have to apply only this, because you are having several formulas, you can apply anything. Second case. One right angle is given, angle C equal to 90. In the previously two perpendicular side lengths are given, A and B. Now let us take one side and the hypotenuse. A and C are given. So in a right angle triangle only, previously two sides and a right angle. Now here one side and one hypotenuse and a right angle. Now, because you are having A and C, so I can apply sin A. Sin A equal to A by C, which implies angle A will be known. And once you know angle A, angle B equal to 90 minus A. And we need to find the length of B. Now, for B, again, you can apply either the right angle triangle property or cos function also can be applied. So, cos A. Cos A equal to B by C. That means B equal to C cos A. Under right angle triangle only, third case. Previously two sides are given and one right angle. Now let us say one right angle, angle C is 90, and one side and one more angle. Let us say B is given and angle B is also given. That is one acute angle. So one right angle, one more side and one more acute angle are given. Now again, one possible solution. So B is given, so this is given, angle B is given. Now, so angle A equal to 90 minus angle B. So this angle also you'll get now. Now sin A. So sin A equal to A upon C. Sin A equal to A upon C. Cos A equal to, so cos A equal to B upon C. Now, here A we know, so cos A we know, as well as B we know. Then from this we can get length of C. Once I get length of C, then from this I'll get length of A. After getting length of A, then I can write as C equal to C square equal to A square plus B square. Even you can write other possibilities also. One more case. So angle C is 90. Previously one side and acute angle we have taken. Now let us say hypotenuse and one acute angle. So one hypotenuse and one acute angle is given along with a right angle. So angle A equal to 90 minus B. So angle A is known, angle B also known, and C also given. Then cos A equal to B by C. Now C we know already and A we know. So from this we can find out the B value. Now B's length of B we know, length of C we know. Now length of A. Sin A equal to A upon C implies you'll get the value of A. Now all the three side lengths we know, and all as well as all the three angles we know. Solution of oblique triangles. Solution of oblique triangles. Oblique triangle means not a right angle triangle. Oblique triangle means other than right angle triangle. Number one, three sides A comma B comma C are given. Three sides A comma B comma C are given. That means three elements are given. Now to find the other three elements, you can have several possibilities. Let us write one possibility. One possible solution to find other three elements. We can apply cosine rules using cosine rules. We can find the three angles, angle A comma, angle B and angle C. Let us write one more method also. We can calculate area of triangle using Heron's formula, S into S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. After finding the area of triangle, you can apply the formula delta equal to half BC sin A. From this you can find the angle A. And half CA sin B. From this you can find the angle B. Half AB sin C. from this you can find the angle C. Or even we can apply the half angle formulas also. Half angle formula. Second case. Two sides and one included angle given. Two sides and one included angle given. So let us say two sides A and B and included angle C given. Two sides and included angle C is given. So one possible solution again. Delta equal to half AB sine C. So we can find the area of the triangle using half AB sine C. Now, after finding area of the triangle, A plus B, because angle C is given, so A plus B equal to 180 minus C, that is sum of the angles you will get. Next, tangent formula. Tan of A minus B by 2 equal to A minus B upon A plus B into cot C by 2, because the side lengths A and B we know and angle C we know, so right side we know. So from this you will get the A minus B. Now solving A minus B and A plus B, then you can find the angles A and B. Now after getting the angle A and angle B and angle C using the sine rule, we can find the length of the side C. That is C by sine C equal to A by sine A. Because A we know and angle A we know, C also we know. So from this we can calculate the length of this side C. Under oblique triangle, third case. One side and two angles are given. One side and two angles are given. Let us say C is given and two angles, angle A and angle C is given. So C given and two angles, angle A and angle C is given. Now one possibility to find the other three elements. Now, once you know two angles, you can add the third angle as angle B equal to 180 minus of A plus C. Now, using sine rule, ए अपान साइन ए इक्वल टू बी अपान साइन बी इक्वल टू सी अपान साइन सी. नाउ सी विनो साइन सी विनो एंड साइन ए विनो. सो फ्रॉम दिस आई विल गेट द लेंथ ऑफ द साइड ए एंड फ्रॉम दिस आई विल गेट द लेंथ ऑफ द साइड बी. Then all the three sides we got, as well as all the three angles we got. In this, one more case. So previously we have taken as one side and two angles, angle A and angle C. Now let us take the included side and the angles. That is C, angle A, angle B are given. So angle A, angle B and angle C is given. Still it will be it will be same as the previous case only. Why? Because once you know two angles, then the third angle will be what? Angle C equal to 180 minus of A plus B. Then you can apply again the same as the previous case. Two sides and an angle opposite to one of them. Two sides and an angle opposite to one of them given. This case is called ambiguous case.
No solution can be found for that.
Two sides and an angle opposite to one of them given. This case is called ambiguous case. Why this case is called ambiguous case? There are three possibilities will be there. Two triangles can be possible, one triangle possible, or no triangle. That's why this case is called ambiguous case. So you can have a case of two triangles, one triangle, and no triangle. Now, let us consider two sides and an angle opposite to one of them. So, I am considering side A, side B, and angle A are given. Here also, you will be having several cases, that is, several ways to describe. Now, so one of the way we are discussing. So two sides A and B and angle A are given. So I am using here cosine rule because I know angle A and side A. So A square equal to B square plus C square minus 2AB cos A. Now, sorry, A square equal to B square plus C square minus 2BC cos A. Now, this will be a quadratic in C. So, C square minus 2BC cos A plus B square minus A square equal to 0. Now, solve the quadratic either by using factorization or by applying the formula. C equal to 2B cos A plus or minus root of 4B square cos square A minus 4 into B square minus A square upon 2. तो सी इक्वल टू बी कॉस ए प्लस आर माइनस रूट ऑफ बी स्क्वायर कॉस स्क्वायर ये माइनस बी स्क्वायर माइनस ऑफ माइनस प्लस ए स्क्वायर दैट इज ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर साइन स्क्वायर ये
सर राघव इज इन द वेटिंग रूम
राघव इज इन वेटिंग रूम
ना सो द लेंथ ऑफ दिस साइड सी विल बी बी कॉस ए प्लस आर माइनस रूट ऑफ ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर साइन स्क्वायर ये ना अंडर दिस अगेन सब केसेस नंबर वन बिकॉज इट इज रूट ऑफ ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर साइन स्क्वायर ये वन सब केस आई कैन टेक एज ए less than b sin a now so one subcase is a less than b sin a when a less than b sin a this inside the root will be negative implies no triangle exists because inside is negative and one more way of explanation is for the same thing if I apply sine rule b upon sine b equal to a upon sine a now from this
sir you got muted So under this first case will be what a less than b sin a. So from this we can conclude that inside is negative. So triangle does not exist. Now one more way of explanation is using sine rule. That is b upon sin b equal to a upon sin a implies sin b equal to b sin a. B sin A upon A. Now, so here we have taken as B sin A greater than A, then with this ratio will be greater than 1. So sin B is greater than 1. So no triangle. And one more way of explanation is geometrical. Now, listen carefully. So geometrical explanation is, that is like a construction. So side A we know, and side B we know, and angle A we know. And another condition is A less than B sin A. Then using the construction with this, we should say that triangle is not possible. Because the length of side B we know, A, C. So I am drawing a line segment AC of length of B and angle A also I know. So this is angle A. Also we know the length of A. Now with the C as center, I can draw an arc with a radius A. Now when I'm drawing an arc with the C as center, that means one possibility can be like this. Or you can have a one more possibility of drawing an arc. Like this also. So these are the three possible arcs. Now, among the three possible arcs because the side length a we know. A we know. And one more condition is A less than B sin A. A less than B sin A. That means B sin A will be again less than B. That means A less than B. Now we are drawing an arc here by taking C as the center and A as the radius. That means this length will be what? A. Arc, this length will be A. Arc, this length will be A. So among all the three arcs, the possible arc we have to take is because A is less than B. This one I should take. R is so this will be what? A less than B. This I think it is not possible.
Yes, sir.
Once again, Alakshya. See, once again, entirely. So there are, with C center and A as a radius, there are three possible arcs. This is one arc, second arc, third arc. Now, first arc is not intersecting this angle, this side A, that is angle A. That means no triangle. So this will be the correct one. Now we have to eliminate the second arc and the third arc. Now, when I consider the second arc, which is a tangent, so this angle will be 90. So sine A equal to A by B. So A equal to B sine A, which is contradicting this condition. That means this is not possible. Now when I consider the third arc, which is intersecting the at two distinct points, then I can consider this is one point B1, another point is B2. Now that means this length, that is C to B2, will be greater than this length. Because this is forming a right angle triangle. Now, in this right angle triangle, this becomes the hypotenuse. B2C will be the hypotenuse. That means B2C will be greater than this. That means A will be greater than B sin A. So A greater than B sin A, which is again contradicting this. That means this is also not possible. That means only this is a curve is possible. That means there is no triangle exists. So, under the case of A equal to B sin A, only one right angle triangle. Now, the third case is A greater than B sin A. So, when A greater than B sin A, that means this is defined. Then you will have two possibilities of C. C equal to B cos A plus, C equal to B cos A minus. Now, let us take in this one sub case again. If B cos A value, see, this will be always defined only?
Yes, sir.
Now, let us take angle A is acute. I'm taking the case. Angle A is acute. That means A side A, side B, and angle A is given. And A greater than B sin A, then I'm taking a subcase as angle A is acute. Now, when angle A is acute, because this is already defined, and angle A acute I am taken, that means this is also defined. That means one triangle is sure. Now we have to check under what condition this will be also possible. Now, when I take angle A is acute, and if I want to have this is also should exist, means B cos A must be greater than. So B cos A must be greater than root of A square minus B square sin square A. Now, implies and implied by B square cos square A plus B square sin square A greater than A square. That means implies and implied by b square greater than a square, which implies and implied by b greater than a. Now that means b greater than a, then two triangles exist. When b greater than a, two triangles exist under the condition of what? Angle A is acute. So angle A is less than 90 degrees. B greater than a, two triangles exist because both are defined. Suppose if b less than a, then one triangle exists. Say geometrically the length of AC is B. So like previously geometrically I can draw a line segment AC, length is B and angle A is acute. This will be the line. With C as center I can draw an arc to intersect AC. Now so one possibility is this. It is intersecting at two points. Then the length of A will be less than B. That A less than B. Two triangles are possible. Now when I draw the arc like this, it is intersecting to the left of A. That means only one triangle is possible. A greater than B. This is a triangle. So you cannot have this triangle. And here, this is one triangle, this is another triangle. So when angle A is obtuse, this is negative. So this second one, C equal to B cos A minus root of A square minus B square sine square A is not possible. Now C will be exist only when B cos A plus root of A square minus B square sine square A must be greater than 0, which implies and implied by A greater than B. That means when A greater than B, one triangle is possible. When A less than B, no triangle is possible under the case of angle A is obtuse. Now, geometrically, you can explain this. So, construct a line segment AC length of B. Now, angle A is obtuse means this is a ray. Now, with C as a center and A as a radius, if I draw this arc, that means A is less than B, so no triangle. And when I draw this arc, that means this length will be same as this length. So A is greater than B. So only one triangle is possible. So when A is a right angle, so this is not possible because negative is there. And C equal to B cos A plus root of cos 90 is 0. So C equal to root of A square. So this will be possible only when A greater than B. That means when A greater than B, one triangle exists, and when A less than B, no triangle. Now geometrically you can explain as draw a line segment AC equal to B and angle A is right angle, draw perpendicular. Now with the C as center and A as a radius, if I draw like this arc, that means here A less than B, so no triangle. When I draw arc like this will be the length of A. That means this will be length of A. A greater than B, so only one triangle exists.